Good morning, Canaan Church Street Hartamas. Welcome all of you for joining us this morning. I'm Jessica, and I hope that you have had a great week. Do let us know where you're tuning in from. And let's say hi to each other on Facebook and YouTube chats. God has been very good to us, both individually and as a church. For the month of October, we have asked some of our church members to record their testimonies so that we can rejoice together and praise God for His faithfulness. We believe that while we are sharing our testimonies for God's work, we glorify Him through praise and thanksgiving. We also believe that testimonies encourage the church. It will always remind us that He is still present and He is with us all the time. Last week, we have heard testimonies from Sister Cecily and Auntie Karen. And for this week, we will be hearing testimonies from Sister Diane and how God has been faithful to her during her difficult times. All right, church, before we start, let's read Psalms chapter 89, verses 1 to 4. I will sing of the Lord's great love forever. With my mouth, I will make your faithfulness known through all generations. I will declare that your love stands firm forever, that you establish your faithfulness in heaven itself. You say, I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant. I will establish your line forever and make your throne firm through all generations.
Magandang hapon po mga kapatid. I thanks God for this privilege to tell everyone that our God is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Isa po ako sa mga milyonong tao nagpapatunay na ang ating Diyos ay buhay, tunay at akin. I thanks God for all the blessings that He has given me and my family. Jesus is my Redeemer. Despite po sa lahat ng aking ginagawang kasalanan, alam ko po na hindi niya ako pinabayaan. At lagi niya akong nire-remind na He is greater than anyone or anything else. God blessed me. God loves me. Kahit akong nakasalanan. Few months ago, I was so upset, depressed. Dahil sa pandemic nito, sabay-sabay o problema na dumating sa akin. Hindi po lingin sa inyo lahat na ako'y nagtatrabaho sa restaurant at isa po ako sa mga super affected. Mentally, emotionally, and most of all, financially. Dumating din yung araw na sabi ko sa sarili ko, Lord, hindi ko na po kaya. But God saves me. He showed me that in Him, nothing is impossible. Just trust in Him. Commit everything to Him. And whatever burdens that we are carrying, kahit feeling natin na hindi na natin kaya, tumawag lang tayo sa Kanya. And God will make a way. Nagpapasalamat din ako sa ating Panginoon dahil kahit kailan, hindi niya ako iniwan. Kahit dumating din yung araw na I am almost given up. Dahil nasa sabay-sabay at walang katapusan problema na aking dinaranas. Pero dahil sa kanyang salita, dahil sa kanyang pangako, nabuhayan at nagkaroon ulit ako ng panibagong pag-asa. Dahil nasabi niya, come to me, those who are heavily laden, and I will give you rest. God is true to His promises. Ang pangako niya ay totoo. At yan ang aking pinaghahawakan. God protects me and keeps me safe, gives my children and my family. God provided all our needs, especially when I don't have anything in me. Those days that I felt so alone, God shows me how much He loves me, how much He cares for me and my family. Kaya huwag tayong mawala ng pag-asa, dahil ang Diyos natin ay hindi natutulog. God will never leave us. God will always protect us. God will always bless us. Dahil laging andyan ang ating Panginoon, kahit kailan, kahit saan. Magdasal lang tayo at magtiwala sa Kanya. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for everything. Thank you for all my blessings. Thank you for providing all my needs. And magpapasalamat ako sa Panginoon, sa kabutihan niya sa aking buhay at sa aking pamilya. Binabalik ko ang lahat ng papuri, pasasalamat sa ngalan ng ating Panginoon, tagapagligtas na si Jesus. All glory belongs to God. Amen. And I just wanna take this opportunity to say thank you so much, Canaan Church, for the blessings that you shared to us on behalf of my colleagues and my friends. Maraming maraming salamat po sa tulong na pinigay niyo sa amin. God bless us all.
Yeah. begin again. My God shall supply.
Jehovah Jireh, rest for me, O Jehovah. Thank you. A blessed Sunday, church. Praise God for the beautiful songs of worship this morning. In praise God that we are here again to lift up the name of the Lord Most High and to listen to His word. And as we go on, may I take this opportunity to invite every Filipino here in Malaysia and around the globe to please join us in our Filipino ministry service at 1:30 this afternoon. You can please watch us live in our page. Praise the Lord. And to this very moment, I am requesting every one of us to set aside everything and let's give our full attention to listen to God's word as Pastor Reverend Daniel Lowe will share to us a message entitled, His Mission, My Mission. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much this morning. We thank you so much for this beautiful opportunity to gather once again for your glory, O God. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for the victory that you had given unto us. We thank you for your providence, your protection in everything so that we are here, O God, standing before you, O God, ready to hear from you, Father. We thank you so much, O God. And we pray, dear Lord, that whatever you prepared for us, we will not miss it, O God, but that we will be receptive to your word and we will apply it, O God. That we will be obedient to you, O God. That we will continue to do your mission to this world, Father. We thank you so much. Bless Pastor Daniel, O God, as he will share your word this morning. Lord, in whatever our condition, whatever our situation, O God, every one of us who gathered in your name, O God, we pray, dear Lord, that you're going to minister to each one of us in accordance to your will. We thank you so much. We pray, dear Lord, that you will give us victory upon victory, O God, to this day onwards. We thank you so much. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. Into this morning, let's give the rest of our time to our pastor.
Hi, everyone. Good morning and welcome to Canaan Church, Sri Hartamas. It's always a joy coming together to worship Him in spirit and in truth. We are so thankful. There are so many things I believe today we can give thanks unto the Lord. We thank God for His provision upon our lives. We thank God most of all for His protection, especially during this time of pandemic. And we thank God that His presence is always upon each and every one of us. So at this moment, let us look to the Lord in prayer as we also desire to hear His precious word. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you. Thank you once again, Lord, for the many precious things that you have done in each one of our lives. We thank you for protecting us. We thank you for providing for us. And most of all, we thank you for the reality of Jesus Christ daily in our lives. Today, as we look into your word, we want to believe again that God, you have a special word for us. Help us, O God, to be strong in your word. And help us, we pray, that you will continue to strengthen our faith in you as we look and listen to your precious word. We want to thank you. In Jesus' name we prayed. Amen. My sharing today is entitled, His Mission, My Mission. I repeat, His Mission, My Mission. Taken from Matthew chapter 24, verses 1 to 14. And let's go along as we read this precious word together. It says, Jesus left the temple and was walking away when his disciples came up to him to call his attention to its buildings. Do you see all these things? He asked. I tell you the truth, not one stone here will be left on another. Every one will be thrown down. As Jesus was sitting on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately. Tell us, they said, when will this happen? And what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age? Jesus answered, watch out that no one deceives you, for many will come in my name, claiming I am the Christ, and will deceive many. You will hear of wars and rumors of wars, but see to it that you are not alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is still to come. Verse 7, nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes in various places. All these are the beginnings of birth pains. Then you will be handed over to be persecuted and put to death, and you will be hated by all nations because of me. At the same time, many will turn away from the faith and will betray and hate each other. And many false prophets will appear and deceive many people. Because of the increase of wickedness, the love of most will grow cold. But he who stands firm to the end will be saved. And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to its nation or to all nations, and then the end will come. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. His mission, my mission. You see, Jesus promised his disciples, if I go, I will come back again. The second coming of Jesus Christ is essential for the fulfillment of Bible prophecy. He shall return to the earth again with his church to establish God's kingdom. And today in our journey through Matthew chapter 24, the drama of Jesus' earthly ministry is almost over. And his disciples are asking this pertinent question. What is the sign of your coming? And when is the end of the world? And Jesus replied, well, take note or watch and do not be deceived. Take note and do not be led astray. And watch out for the events that occur before the end of the world. See, God gave us his word so that we may know the truth about the end times and be prepared for its coming. At the same time, he wants us to see the importance of his mission on earth. And in his absence, we will continue on his mission before he comes again. And the scriptures taken from Matthew chapter 24, verses 1 to 14, calls really for a serious undertaking of God's mission. And today, I'd like to share with you three main concerns, and we are going to look into these that really reflect and challenge us that his mission is my mission or our mission. And the first is this: the conditions of the world calls for an awakening. The Bible tells us that there will be worldwide calamity. There will be natural disasters in the form of wars, famines, and earthquakes before the end of the world. And as we know, many of these have been happening for a long time, but some seems to be happening and seems to be increasing. It will even happen in places that are not supposed to happen. For example, the recent earthquake in Melbourne, Australia. And Melbourne is listed as top 10 safest cities to live in the world. And yet, the recent earthquake has actually shocked the entire city and the citizens of Australia. You know, in verses 4 to 14, we have four indicators that show what will happen before the coming of Jesus Christ again. four indicators. Firstly, it says that in verses 4 to 5, there will be great spiritual deception. Jesus answered, "Watch out that no one deceives you, for many will come in my name, claiming I am the Christ, and will deceive many." Second indicator is there will be great political unrest. Verses 6 to 7, it says, "You will hear of wars and rumors of wars, but see to it that you are not alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is still to come. Nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom." Third indicator, there will be great natural disasters. Verse 7, there will be famines and earthquakes in various places. And the last indicator is there will be great religious persecution. Verses 8 to 9, all these are the beginning of repentance. Then you will be handed over to be persecuted and put to death, and you will be hated by all nations because of me. This is really a wake-up call or an awakening for us. It is an awakening to reflect on our walk with God and to redirect our attention back to God. Sometimes our attention is on the wrong things. And sometimes our attention, or most of the time our attention, is on the temporal rather than the eternal. You know, at the end of the day, the only thing that will stay standing is our spiritual aspect. Therefore, friends, we really need to establish a strong relationship in our faith in Jesus Christ. Things are not getting better. All of us know. I'm not a prophet of doom, but that is what the Word of God said. What's happening around the world and with this COVID-19 pandemic are indicators that Jesus is coming back. And let us wake up and stand firm in the Lord. The conditions of the world calls for an awakening. And the second concerns, I believe, is this, that the cry of the dying souls calls for a savior. I repeat, the cry of the dying souls calls for a savior. Verse 9, it talks about martyrdom. Christians have always been hated by the world, and history has confirmed to us. But here we have an acceleration of persecution and martyrdom. And this began shortly through history after the day of Pentecost, when Stephen and James were slain and disciples were scattered because of persecution. And who is not familiar with the terrible stories of Christians who were thrown to lions, burned as human torches, tortured or martyred in other dreadful ways? Another great period of martyrdom broke out at the time of the Reformation period, that is in the 16th and 17th centuries. Then more were persecuted, tortured, and died, especially during World War II in the 20th century. Said that this worldwide persecution towards Christians are still ongoing and is getting worse. In fact, in verse 10 to 13, it also talks about worldwide chaos. Those who once were true to each other will betray each other. And this suggests that like marriages, homes, and even nations, will be torn apart because of lack of loyalty and patriotism. Lawlessness will abound. The law enforcement agencies will not be able to keep the peace. Worse, the law enforcement agencies themselves are not following the law. And the condition of the hearts of many people worldwide simply reveals the seriousness of the depravity of mankind. Unrest, hatred, bitterness, anger, intolerance, rebelliousness, and fighting for justice simply echoes the urgency of an immediate solution to the spiritual decay of man's heart. That's why verse 12 says, because of the increased of wickedness, the love of most will grow cold. And at the same time, there are many people crying out for peace, for love, and also for justice. You know, friends, only Jesus is able to mend the crying heart of the dying souls worldwide. So in Matthew 24 verse 13 says, but he who stands firm will be saved. Are you willing to live and die for Christ in a world that is not tolerant to Christians? This is a reality. We might be tolerant to others because of the love of Jesus Christ, but the truth is that many will increasingly oppose and hate Christians and attempt to eliminate all those who are faithful to Jesus Christ. That's why we need to constantly pray for one another and constantly pray for the salvation of mankind. So are we living in a world of confusion and chaos? And as we are living, definitely, in this world of confusion and chaos, the cry of the dying souls calls for a Savior. We need to step up by His grace and through the power of the Holy Spirit to see the urgency of sharing God's love to this dying world. Only Jesus is able to redeem mankind and restore back the world that is broken. And last but not least, the third concern is that the core message of the kingdom of heaven calls for a messenger. Verse 14, it says, and this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all nations, and then the end will come. You know, as much as wickedness is increasing and the world is not getting any better, God is not losing the battle. Amen. Thank God, the advancement of the gospel is also intensifying. There will be more sharing of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And God's people like you and I need to step up the pace in the preaching and witnessing. We need to step up in terms of sharing the love of Jesus Christ. We need to be witnessing and speak out more for Christ. Christ's mission is also our mission. You know, Albert Einstein, he said this, the world is a dangerous place not because of people who do evil, but because of good people who look on and do nothing about it. You see, the message of the kingdom of heaven really calls for a messenger. Will you be that messenger? Will you answer the call? You know, today the message of God's word is made available through various communication platforms. And because of the advanced technology, it is easily accessible in terms of hearing the word of God. But however, there are some people that only you can reach out to. People need the Lord, and you are the messenger of God's message of love. As I said, there are so many avenues, platforms like YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, whatever it is, and every day you can actually listen to the gospel of Jesus Christ. But somehow, God has placed us where we are. God has put us in Canaan Church with a purpose. That is, you and I are only able to reach out to the people that God has put into our lives. And I trust and pray that you will see the importance of God's mission that God has placed upon your life and the church. You know, in Romans chapter 10, verses 14 to 15, a very interesting passage that talks about who is going to obey the call. It says, how then can they call on the one they have not believed in? And how can they believe in the one of whom they have not heard? And how can they hear without someone preaching to them? And how can anyone preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. In fact, in Psalm 67, verse 2, the Living Bible says this, send us around the world with the news of your saving power and your eternal plan for all mankind. You know, in conclusion, may I encourage you to do not just look for signs and not doing anything about it. There's so many things that are happening around us. But may I encourage you today to look to Jesus, our Savior, for salvation and direction in life. Then do not just allow or let the bad news alarm you. Concentrate on the good news. Every day when you look at the online news or newspaper or TV news, you know, everything is bad news. And every day when you look at indicators, you know, there are so many things I do not think that it is really encouraging us. But we need to look into things that are good. Look into the Word of God. The Word of God is good news to us. The Word of God is able to encourage us. The Word of God is able to help us to be firm in the midst of all this bad news. We know that God has given us that good news. We have a hope and we have a future in Jesus Christ. So do not be fearful by trials or even persecutions that might come, that might deter us from our primary mission. May I encourage you today, friends, live for Jesus and tell everyone how good and loving is our Savior. Jesus Christ, He is the only way, the truth, and the life. He is indeed the hope of the world. You know, Colinia Anoda Johanna, well known as Corrie ten Boom. She was a Dutch Christian watchmaker and later a writer who worked with her father as well as her sister and other family members to help many Jewish people escape from the Nazis during the Holocaust in World War II by hiding them in her home. She believed her actions were following the will of God. They were caught, and she was arrested and sent to the concentration camp. And her famous book, The Hiding Place, is really a biography that recounts the story of her family's efforts and how she found and shaped or shared hope in God while she was imprisoned at the concentration camp. And one of her famous quotes is this: "Time is short, eternity is long. Let us be busy in the Lord's work and ask Him to use us to bring others to Him." Friends, will you make His mission your mission today? And remember these three concerns. The conditions of the world calls for an awakening. Secondly, the cry of the dying souls calls for a savior. And thirdly, the core message of the kingdom of heaven calls for a messenger. You know, friends, there are so many things that are happening around us today. Even with this COVID-19, there's so many people who felt hopeless, who felt helpless. At the same time, they are searching for the reality of God in their lives. Things that are happening around us, we cannot control. But there is one thing we know very well, that as believers of the Lord Jesus Christ, we can always look to the Savior. We can always look to Him, who is able to redeem us, who is able to guide us, who is able to help us. Jesus Christ, as we know, is the only hope of the world. And God has given us a mission in life. That as much as we desire to have a better life, but always remember, the question is, what on earth am I here? I believe God has raised us up. God has redeemed us so that we will fulfill His mission on earth. Remember that you will only be able to reach out to your family members, to your loved ones, to your friends, to your circle of influence. And today I pray that God, through the power of the Holy Spirit, will give you that strength, will give you that confidence, and will give you that assurance that when you share the gospel, He is with you. And I pray that you will always have the urgency of reaching out and share the love of Jesus Christ. We as a church, I believe God has called us to obey the Great Commission. And it is my prayer that you and I today will step up and do the work of God with great faith in us, asking God by His grace and through the power of the Holy Spirit to enable us to witness and share the love of Jesus Christ. His mission is our mission. Lord, thank you for your word today, and we pray that you will help us not just to always concentrate on our own daily lives, but help us to see at the same time the importance of people. There are many who are crying for help today. There are many who are crying and searching for the reality of Jesus Christ. As we know that God, you have redeemed us, that you have given us and poured out your blessing upon our lives, upon our family, help us, O God, to not take things for granted, but at the same time, help us, O God, to do the work that you have called us to do. Give us boldness. Give us, O God, the courage and also the confidence to share the gospel in a very creative manner. We pray for everyone today, dear God, that we pray in Jesus' name, that the love of Jesus Christ, that the wisdom of God and the power of the Holy Spirit will always be upon us, so that, God, we will be able to win souls for you. Lord, we thank you. Even as we go, we pray, dear God, that indeed you will continue to help us to stand firm till the end. As we know, dear God, you are coming again. Help us to always remember the call that you have placed upon our life. Help us to be that messenger to share the good news to everyone around us. As we go, continue to go with us with your presence. Continue to protect us and continue, Lord, to help us throughout this week to cherish the moments that we have with you. We thank you and we pray that, dear God, you will give us the strength to really win people to the Lord Jesus Christ. We want to thank you. Go with us, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.
Share. People need